Hi, I'm Mike Bird. I work in the area of arts and humanities, more specifically religious studies, more specifically New Testament theology and early Christian history. Like many of you, I am wrestling with the effects of AI upon my own discipline. The primary and presenting issue I've got to confront, of course, is that of plagiarism. I mean, and there is something of an arms race going on at the moment between people who want to use AI to create research and write automatically essays. And then on the other hand, there are those who are trying to do AI detection software who are trying to find people who are using AI to present assessment that they're submitting. But beyond that, there's a lot of other things happening in this area. There's a lot of really good tools that are out there that you can use. So if you're an academic or a student, and you want to know about some really nifty tools to help you out in your research, your studies, and your general sort of work in the academic sphere, I've identified several that you might find pretty helpful. First of all, as you all know, there is ChatGPT. This is the thing that's caused the revolution, if you like, that we're dealing with. And I found ChatGPT quite helpful for a number of things. It's good for creating outlines on a given topic, like what are the top five things students need to know about Ignatius of Antioch. It's also good for some creative tasks, like create a song about the church father Athanasius, based on the tune Rock Me Amadeus by Falco. It's also good for things like generating bibliographies, but along the way, you often have to tweak it. Let me give you an example of what I mean. Now, if you look at the screen here, you can see basically a ChatGPT page. So let me type something into that we might find helpful. Let me put in what are the top five resources that students should read about Constantine. Now you can tell from the screen, it's come up with some pretty good resources. You've got the book by David Potter, another one by Michael Grant, Hans Poulsländer, Charles Mattson, that's pretty good too, and The Age of Constantine. But it's missing my favorite resource, which is the one by Timothy Barnes. So let me add in the volume by Timothy Barnes. Let me tell it what to do. Add in the book by Timothy Barnes. Yeah, you can now see it's adding Timothy Barnes there. I think he's probably written the one of the best books on Constantine, certainly when it comes to Constantine and Eusebius, and that's a pretty good summary. The other good thing about ChatGPT is it does have a pretty good translation function. So let's say you're reading something in German, Italian, Spanish, maybe your European languages or other languages are a little bit rusty since you did your doctoral studies and you need a little bit of help in translation. Well, what you can do is go into ChatGPT, and I cut and paste it in there, and then I say, please translate into English. Let's see what it comes up with. Yeah, that's a pretty good summary of what Ruben Bunner's written there. As far as I can tell, take it as a whole, the present study provides an impressive panorama. Yeah, in this sum, yep, it sounds pretty good. So there you go, another use for ChatGPT. But there is another thing you can do with ChatGPT, and that is you can enter a student's essay in it and get feedback. And this is the bit I found very interesting. So watch what I do here. So right now I'm going to put in one of the old essays I did when I was in seminary, and then I'm going to ask ChatGPT to provide feedback. So watch what happens when I do this. Provide feedback to this essay. You can see there it's provided some feedback, but let's ask how could this essay be improved? Now you can see here how it's providing some advice on how the essay could be improved, could benefit from a clearer structure. Some sentences and paragraph are quite long and complex. We can ensure some of this is basic advice. There's a number of things you could use this for. Students could use this as a way of getting some tutorial feedback on their writing style. So to help them improve their English expression, their structure, their sentence construction, and the like would be very useful for that. Also, for academics, if you enter a student's essay in and you get it from feedback, it may help you generate the word picture you can use in providing feedback to students. Another interesting tool is Perplexity. Now, this is a little bit different to ChatGPT, and it's also different to, say, your average Google search. So a Google search will just give you a bunch of websites you can look at with information, whereas ChatGPT does the synthesis of those searches for you. Perplexity is somewhat in between. It gives you a synthesis of information, but what it also does is shows you where it gets the information from. So let me give you a demonstration of that. Okay, here we are on the Perplexity homepage, and look at the question I'm going to ask it. Did Paul write Philippians from Rome or Ephesus? This is actually a big question in Pauline studies. And I think the tide is changing. I think more people are seeing Philippians as written from Ephesus than Rome. But let's see what it says. Okay, searching. Yep, there definitely is a debate among scholars. Now you can see this. It's given you a basic summary, but it also tells you where it's getting the information from. So it's kind of like ChatGPT, albeit with footnotes. And you can actually go to these footnotes. Let's go to the first one, which we can see will be from the Sage article. Let's see what we can find there. So again, here we have an article by Michael Flexenhagen, who is writing on the provenance of Philippians, why it matters, new approaches. That's from JSNT, very reputable source, the type of place I would want to direct students to looking at. So yeah, Perplexity, I think, is pretty good. It's kind of like a halfway house between a Google search and ChatGPT. So that's the kind of resource you might find helpful if you want to know where the AI is getting its information from, and then you can follow it up yourself and perhaps test, qualify, or amend the summaries that you've been presented with. There's also a number of resources you can use to help you interrogate and summarize essays you have in your collection. So if you've got a journal article or an essay from your book, it's in your file of PDFs. It's not on the internet necessarily, so you can't get ChatGPT to search it. What you can do is go to a number of different AI platforms that help you download and then explore, summarize, interrogate PDFs and articles. There's a number of these. The one I would recommend is Humata. Another good one is Explain Paper. But let's go to. But probably the number one AI tool that I found the most useful, the most helpful as a lecturer and academic dean is a plugin called Monica. This is an immensely helpful tool that is, it's kind of like a cross between Siri, on your iPhone and ChatGPT. And it enables you to direct very intentionally some AI tools to some very mundane tasks, ranging from writing an email, writing a blog post, writing an article, doing some daily stuff, and it really does save time, and I have found it immensely useful. So let me give you a demonstration of Monica in action. So here we are. This is a new site. So I click on the Monica icon, which is on my screen, and you can see on the right-hand side, I've got another things I can chat, compose. I can simply ask it a question down here. That could be something as mundane as like, what year did Athanasius die? And you can see it pretty much comes up here. It's good and it knows about it. But let's say I want to compose something. Okay, what I want to do is I want to compose an email warning students of the dangers of using AI in their essays and running afoul of plagiarism plagiarism regulations. So, and I want that to be short. I want it to be an email and I want it to be professional. And I go generate draft. And you can see down here, it's basically created something along those lines. Yeah, I find that very, very helpful. And there's also several templates you can use here as well. But let's try something a bit different now. And this is something I have generally used it for. Okay. Compose a tweet promoting a course. Sorry, my spelling's not great. Course on the Gospel of Matthew for Ridley College's online live initiative and explain why students will benefit from doing it. So that's what I've got. I want something again short. I want this to be something that's going to go out on Twitter and I want it to be friendly. So let's see what it generates now. Again, if you look down here, you can see a whole bunch of emojis and icons. Exciting news. Ridley College is offering an online course on the Gospel of Matthew. Join us and discover the rich history and the teachings of this beloved book. Whether you're a seasoned theologian or just starting out, this course will deepen your understanding. So yeah, you can see how it's very useful for that. So if you've got to do a few mundane tasks, whether that's emails, tweets, or even just searching for information, I find this a far more easier way to access some AI search engines than what you would normally be using. So Monica, I find, is a very good plugin. It's a good way to get quick access to AI technology for a bunch of tasks, writing social media posts, emails, some automatic searches. You know, when you search something on Google, you know, you'll put in, but you'll get like 20 answers. Normally you'll get something straight away from Monica. That said, you do have to be careful because not all of its answers are correct. I put in a question before about which Roman emperor persecuted John Chrysostom, one of the church fathers, and it got it wrong. It said it was Theodosius the second, when in fact it was Theodosius the first. So you've got to be discerning and you frequently do have to check some stuff. So there you are. That's the use of AI in the arts and humanities, the stuff on ChatGPT, Perplexity, Monica, a few different resources out there for interrogating and summarizing files on your computer. And of course, there is also Fireflies. If I have missed any, and there are some really good tools out there that people need to know about, please throw it down in the comments section. You'll be doing me and a whole bunch of other people some really good favors. So hope you enjoyed that. And if you like, I might see you around the channel on some other time.